match and Pondicherry match. So I thank all the 13 branches students and the Sicasa chairman for participating in this thing. Due to the time factor, I directly give the podium to Manoharan sir. Sir, please do come. Thank you, sir.
Thanks to the immediate past chairman of Salem branch, C.A. Shankar, for the introductory remarks. Now, as far as this session is concerned, it's all about examination. Now I, of course, there are many students who have joined virtually from different branches, so I wholeheartedly welcome all of them to the session virtually. And there are also students at the premises of the Salem branch who are physically participating in the session. So just as a symbolic survey, I want to ask those who are physically present here as to how many of you are appearing for coming May exam. Some of them are there, three, okay. How many in November? Okay, significant number. So, now actually CA examinations by itself is not tough or challenging, as I was mentioning the it all depends on how you take it up, how you equip yourself, how you plan your approach to the examination. So it all depends on that. In terms of the, you know, changes that are happening in the curriculum or the syllabus or the pattern of the examination, all those things, these are all inevitable. Charles Darwin is most apt for CA students because it's not your strength, it is not your intelligence that will ultimately make you pass. It is your ability to adapt to the expectation. What is expected of you in the CA examination? So how you are empowered to do that, or equipped to do that, that will be determinant of your success in the examination. It is, you know, at the foundation level, entrance examination level, basic knowledge is enough. At the intermediate level, reasonable working knowledge is required. But at the final level, advanced level of knowledge is required. Analytical approach is required. Case study solving methodology is required. So that is what you will have to change your approach in empowering yourself to face those kind of questions. Now, in terms of the journey during this 3 to 5 years of your CA journey, you have to dream big. What do I mean by dreaming big? See, if I ask all of you, what is your dream? You are going to say, I want to pass CA exam, or I want to qualify as a chartered accountant. But when you are having that dream, why not, instead of just dreaming to pass, why not dream big to say, I want to pass with an All India rank? Does it cost you anything, dreaming big? Can anybody deprive you or prevent you from dreaming big? Nobody. It is your inherent right to dream big. So instead of merely dreaming to qualify as a chartered accountant, dream bigger to qualify with an All India rank. Never compromise or think that you are not capable of getting an All India rank. That is not what a champion thinks. A champion thinks, I am not inferior to anybody. I can achieve what others think is impossible. And when you are the rank holder, what happens? What happens is, See, if you merely pass, maybe you are chasing opportunities. But when you qualify with an All India rank, maybe opportunities will chase you. So that transformation happens. So putting that little extra effort, running that extra mile, if it can get you a rank, this is the time for you to plan and do it. So that is what I mean by dream big. Then design your path. So to achieve your dream, which you are conceptualizing in your mind, to translate that into reality, you have to design your path. How are you going to use the time available before the examination? So that study all days, now even when you are going for articleship training, you will have surplus time or rather free time either in the morning, evening or weekends. So how are you going to utilize it for the purpose of academic preparation to equip yourself to face the examination? That is designing your path. Then ultimately, however tough it may look to be, you will achieve the goal. You will reach your destination. So that is the next thing which you will have to be conscious about. Then there are certain prerequisites for you to be successful in life. What are those prerequisites? You have to have the aspiration to become a professional. Maybe in some of your families, you may be the first chartered accountant to qualify, aspiring to qualify as a chartered accountant. Maybe some of you may be second generation, third generation. But that aspiration should be driven by your zeal. Is it connected? Yeah. Is it good enough? Strong enough? Prerequisites that I have listed out here. The first one is aspiration. As I said, it is nothing but a burning desire, a zeal to give your best to achieve what you want to accomplish. So that is aspiration. The second thing is, there is no substitute for hard work, that you would have heard it from many people. Only thing is, here you should, it's not bulwark we are talking about. When I say hard work, is not blindly reading hours and hours together. You will have to strategically prepare yourself and channelize your energy to become successful. So the method of preparation, the way in which you prepare, makes world of difference. 10 times you read the same thing, but with no grasping or clarity or mastering of the subject,
it's not going to take you anywhere.
But, you know, one round of familiarization, second round of in-depth preparation, jotting down points, taking notes, working out illustrations, example. Third round of mastering round, or filling up, bridging the gaps, tying up the loose ends, removing doubts on gray areas. These are all step by step. If you do, instead of 10 times, it is enough if you read 3 times. I mean, 3 rounds of preparation, that will give you completeness in terms of mastery of the subject. Self-confidence. Many of us have to get out of this inferiority complex. Because if you want to decide on taking up something, and if you are not confident of it, then you are passing a no confidence motion on yourself. That should not be the case. If you are having absolute confidence in you, even if the rest of the world does not believe in you, you will achieve anything you want. On the contrary, even if the whole world expects you to achieve based on your past track record, but if you are not having self-confidence, you cannot achieve anything at all. So both are true. So unless you have absolute confidence, self-confidence is very, very important. There should be no dilution of self-confidence. If maybe some examples I'll give out of my own life's journey. When I joined a pre-university, which is equivalent to 12th standard now, because those days only up to 11th schools taught, 12th we have to join a college where it will be pre-university college degree, so PUC, then graduation, 3 years. So PUC, when I joined in our own village, nearby village, Government Arts College in Gudiyatta, first question I went and inquired with the teachers, professors, was how many students have passed in first class? Those days first class, second class, third class, those are the 3 things. So they said, from the inception of the college till now, nobody has passed first class in arts group. That is, arts group is history, economics, commerce. That is the arts group with the languages. So nobody has got first class. So I was so depressed when I heard that news. In such a college I have come and joined. Then there used to be a study table, 2x2 study table in my village house, where I was born and brought up. Basically agriculturist. So one chair, wooden chair and wooden table, and that is the place where I used to sit and prepare in night. Daytime, I used to go to fields, our lands, and sit there and prepare under the shadow of a tree. And in front of that study table, I wrote in a slip of paper, if they cannot, it doesn't mean that I cannot. அவர்களால் முடியாது என்றால் என்னால் முடியாது என்று அர்த்தம் இல்லை. So that is what I wrote. So I used to look at that statement which I myself wrote every day before preparing. So it kept on registering in my mind. That subconscious mind started believing it. If they cannot, it doesn't mean that I cannot. And I prepared, I wrote the exam. 100 people wrote, and only 13 of them passed, 87 failed. Failed means one paper or the other, because that is the level of education those days in that rural belt. And out of the 13, 11 got third class, one got second class, and the only one person got first class. I know, I need not tell you, that was myself. The reason why I could do it was self-confidence. That if they cannot do it, doesn't mean that I cannot do. So if you have self-confidence, you can accomplish what you want to accomplish. Then you must also have this dedication. What is dedication? Dedication is involving in what you are doing wholeheartedly without any distractions. In fact,
we did not have so much of distractions as you are having now. Your challenges are in gadgets and screens, mobile screen, laptop screen, iPad screen, TV screen, like that. You have so many screens that can take away your precious time. That is where you have to have, that dedication will help you. In fact, dedication teaches you how to invest time, not spend time. You should know the difference between spending time and investing time. If you are able to invest time for the goal that you want to achieve, then no distractions will be entertained. Even once in a while you want to relax, your discipline will be ensured. That limited time, during that predetermined hour, you may relax, listening to a music or watching a particular thing. But the point is, you should not be addicted to anything that distracts you. You should be in control of things, not those things should control you. So that temptation should not be entertained at all. So, in fact, I am confident you are all not addicted to watching TV serials, but that is the worst thing that can happen to a youngster. Of course, elderly people, housewives, that is their hobby, that is their emotional outlet. They are, that is the best thing they can do to relax and also to while away the time, and what emotions they cannot show to their family members, they can enjoy the characters showing it to other characters. That gives them some great relief also. But you cannot afford to get addicted to it, because these TV serials are beyond the life length of human life. They will keep going on. It will never end. And you cannot say after this TV serial gets concluded. No, actually your exams will be over before this period. And even after you complete the qualifying exam, if you watch that, it will be understandable. Only characters, even the heroine dies, they will make a substitute heroine and continue the shooting, isn't it? That's what happens. But you cannot afford to while away your time getting distracted. So dedication will prevent distractions. Now, what is determination? Determination is in a sense, not giving up. Because there will be situations where your morale is affected, your confidence level is dipped. That's bound to happen. Ups and downs will be there. But only your determination will help you to cross the finishing line. So you don't give up halfway through. So you are bent upon progressing in that path so that you take it to logical conclusion. Then comes the strategy. There are, see, prerequisites, I have said 5 prerequisites. Now in terms of strategy, I have 5 P's. Easy to remember, 5 P's. First one is the passion. See, unless you are proud of what you want to become, you cannot have that passion. Namesake, you cannot be doing something. I have asked CA students, why you want to become a chartered? So some have said, I want to become a chartered. That is the right answer I would expect, because you should be passionate about becoming a chartered accountant. Some may say, my father wants me to become a chartered accountant, my uncle wants me, my mother wants me. Some have said, my wife wants me to become a chartered accountant. I mean, some people join after marriage. So, all this is okay. Where from the motivation comes could be different. But once you join, it should become as self-interest, passion by yourself. So, you should own it up. Not an imposed mandate or a goal, but it is a self-embarked upon task of qualifying as a chartered accountant. Then planning. Planning is very, very fundamental and important. That's why they say, if you are failing to plan, that means you are planning to fail. So planning is inevitable. Now, what is planning? Planning is about how are you going to devote the time, to which subject, how much, when to study which subject, what book has to be studied for which subject. All these are all part of the planning. So that planning, for example, most of you raised the hand you are appearing for November, eligible to appear for November. So you have to cancel it. You know, your preparation should end by September. It should not go to October at all. So by 30th September, for November exam, if you have to complete all the three rounds, familiarization round, in-depth preparation round and mastery round, all this you have to complete before September 30th. You should have your calendar prepared. Even if you have not done already, do it from tomorrow. From tomorrow till 30th September, count how many days are there, how many hours are there. Now, whichever all the time you can devote for studying, so which subject, what timetable, all that you will have to plan. And the chapter-wise, you can factor, you know, this 10 to 11, I mean, early morning 5 to 7, I have to complete this portion for 3 days. This chapter should be over for 5 days. Like that, if you keep filling up, targeting completion of syllabus, you will be in control of things. That is the proper way to plan. Actually, if you, in the first round of allocating time, if you start allocating time, I mean each month you can download. May month, June month, July, August, September, 5 months, you download those calendar. April, whatever remaining time. And you try to fill it up for the hours of study. And the syllabus, you try to fit in the syllabus. First time when you do that, the syllabus will get completed in January. I mean, it will go up to that. Now you will think, 5 months are there, 5 months are there. No, you don't know how insufficient it can become if you don't plan properly. Then you will, then you will condense and try to push it back. To finish. Then third time you will succeed in fitting it up to September. And that is how you should know the value of time, scarcity of time, inadequacy of time. Actually, if you know the inadequacy of time, you will make it adequate. In fact, you can make it surplus also. So that is how this planning assumes significance. Then preparation. Preparation should be basically by the method of how your exams are testing you. How you are tested in your examination or by the answers you write, isn't it? Now, day-to-day life in your office or anywhere, how much you are writing? Writing has come down drastically, isn't it? You are more using operating laptops, computers. You are typing. Whereas in exam, you are expected to write. In 3 hours, you have to answer 100 marks. So that, there is a mismatch. When we were doing CA, we used to write in the office everywhere. Everywhere we used to prepare manually. Everything. Profit loss account, balance sheet, all those things. We will prepare and then give it for typing. That was the, not in computers, in typewriters. And so, we were trained in the office to write the exams. That writing habit was there. Now it is not there. So therefore, in your preparation time, you have to prepare by the method of writing, by the method of solving. As many pages you exhaust, the better it is. So that you will be more equipped to write. In fact, if you don't write at all in the preparation time and go straight to the exam, you may know all the answers. But to write it, you will be struggling. After every half an hour, you will keep the pen and you will start massaging the fingers. Because fingers are requesting, Arey Baba, you have never used me like this. Why you are torturing me? You have to train. See, even now, right now, if I start dictating 2 pages of a matter at a particular speed, 50% of you may be able to cope up in writing what I am dictating. Another 30% may capture 70% of what I am dictating and miss the remaining words. And 20% may not be able to capture anything at all. That may be the difference in the level of your speed of writing. That you will have to improve. I can slow down my dictation so that everybody can write and capture every word I am dictating. That is possible. But that is not possible in the examination. You have to improve the speed of writing so that you can answer all the questions. See, you hear no students coming out of the exam hall and saying, I knew the answers for all the 100 marks, but I could attempt only 70 marks. 30 marks, what happened? Time was insufficient. You wanted 4 hours for the exam, whereas institute gives only 3 hours. So you cannot expect the number of hours to be increased. You have to expect your speed to be increased. And normally when you, in a short time, when you try to increase the speed, you start committing mistakes. So you have to improve your speed gradually so that with accuracy the speed improves. And you are able to express your answers clearly with clarity, quality, legibility. Some of the students I used to find, I mean the examination answer sheets, first few pages anybody can read. Next few pages only the student who wrote can read. The last few pages, I don't think even that student can read what he wrote. So that is not acceptable. Last page should have the same clarity as the first page. That will you get it only by practice. So the preparation methodology itself should be by writing, by solving problems, by working out illustrations, exhausting as many pages as possible. So all that has to be done. One person wanted to become an expert in shooting. So he approached a trainer. He said, okay, I'll buy you a gun and a license. I'm going out of station. After 1 week, I'll come and train you. So he bought the gun license and he left out of station. After 1 week, he came. He asked, where should we practice? He said, sir, I have already prepared a backyard of my house. There's a big wall. We can use that as a shooting range here. So please come to my house. So the trainer goes to his house, they go to the backyard, and there's a big wall which can be used for shooting range. The trainer is surprised that on that wall there are circles of different size, and in every circle there is a bullet mark in the center, bullseye. So he asked, who shot so perfectly? He said, I only shot, sir. Well, you are shot so perfectly, why do you need training? You teach me how to shoot so perfectly, the trainer asked. For that, this person said, sir, there is only one difference. You people draw the circle and shoot. I shoot and then go draw the circle. That's the only difference. That is not possible in the examination. You have to adapt to the expectations of the examination and accordingly upgrade your skills. That is the only way, because it's a competitive world. You are not competing with those who are in this room alone. You are competing with all the students across India and maybe abroad also. So that is how your standard has to be improved in terms of the quality of preparation and the practice to perform. So when you ultimately, you have to complete presentation by 3 hours, which means that you can achieve it only by writing model exams. I told you, know your preparation should stop by September 30th for November exam. What is that you should do in October? October should be for revising and writing model exams. In fact, I asked one batch of students, after you complete preparation, before the examination, what do you do? I asked. They were blank. I repeated the question. After completing your preparation, before the examination, what do you do? One student stood up and said, sir, we keep on preparing. Exam comes, we write the exam. There is no gap between completing preparation and examination. That too is unknown to us. That's why I am telling you, complete your preparation by 30th September. Exam is going to start on 1st November. October, use it for writing model exams, revising the syllabus, subject and writing model exam. So that is how you have to practice to perform. Now when you practice to perform, you should raise your bar. How do you raise your bar? Normal exam is for 3 hours. Model exam, you try to finish that paper in 2 hours 45 minutes. Train yourself with a higher standard. Once you practice like that, then what will happen? In the examination hall, at least for each group, there will be one paper which will be a shocker, surprise, lengthy question paper. All that will come in each group. You have to be mentally prepared for that. The only certainty of SE exam is uncertainty. So you have to be prepared for that. Now, suppose a time-consuming question paper, you know, comes. Others will be struggling to finish in 3 hours. Now you, since you have the ability to finish in 2 hours 45 minutes, that 15 minutes surplus will come, have an edge, will give you an edge to complete even such a time consuming paper. That, so increase the bar when you are rehearsing. Rehearsing means writing model exams. So that way you should practice to perform. And in CA exams, sometimes what happens, beyond your control, sometimes things may go wrong, things may result may not be favorable. It happens. You should have perseverance. That is the last P. 50% is mind game. How strong you are, how stable. You know, perseverance is not only for one attempt to another attempt, perseverance. Even within this attempt, you can convert a failure into a success. How? Suppose you, you are writing the exams. I'll give you a typical example of a student who China. She was deputed by India to China for 2 years. She learned the Mandarin language also. Now she is back in Delhi serving the External Affairs Ministry. She was my student. And her parents called me and said, "Sir, she has written 5 subjects out of 8 papers final. She has written 5 papers. Now she says she wants to skip. She doesn't want to write the remaining 3 papers. She says she will prepare better, write next attempt and get all India rank. She doesn't want to attempt these 3 papers. But we feel she should not do this. But as parents, we have limitation in pressurizing beyond a point. It should not boomerang. Youth are capable, no, to take some other drastic measure also. They were worried. So they connected me. I said, I'll talk to her. So I spoke to her. Fortunately, because I taught her, that genuine respect was there. So in my conversation, the first thing I did was I shook her psychological by talking little harsher in the sense I said, I never thought you are such a negative personality. I thought you are a positive person. Like that, she was taken aback. Because when realized paper I wrote, second paper I wrote, third paper, all were average. In our evaluation, it was average performance. She wanted a bright, outstanding performance, but according to her, moderate performance. Okay, one group over, 4 papers. Let me see whether in second group I can give an outstanding performance. So fifth paper I went, that also was average, moderate. Then I thought, why write another 3 papers? Anyway, I may fail. Why write? I told her, see, all those who have failed or those who did not know how close they were to success when they gave it up. So, giving up doesn't mean you are going up. You should cross the finishing line. See, by not writing these 3 papers, what are you achieving? You are converting the probability of success into a certain failure, undoubted failure, isn't it? By writing those 3 papers, what is that you are trying to do? the potential failure, you are exploring the opportunity of converting it into a success. That's all. So which one is better? Will you feel happy sitting at home and those three papers exams are being held by and your batchmates and your colleagues, peers are writing there and you are sitting in there waiting for next 6 months later? Is that what you want? So I brainwashed her and she committed to me, okay sir, for your sake I'll go and write the three papers. I said, just be a robot, don't be a human being. Human beings are emotional, robots are not. Isn't it? Are not supposed to be. When they get emotions, this problem for human beings that you would have seen in Rajinikanth's movie. Now the point is, be a robo, non-emotional, just go, revise, go, give your best, come back. Forget about it. Next exam, next exam. She wrote like that, all the eight, remaining three also. And we forgot about the whole thing and became busy in our own life. When the results came, I got a call from her. Then only I remembered, oh, today's results and this one. So when the call came, she was crying over the phone. I thought, gone. But then she said, I passed both the groups. And I'm crying because imagine if I had gone ahead with my decision not to write the three papers. Definitely I would have failed. And again to clear this attempt, this was the problem. Next attempt there could have been some other. So when I might have missed the bus. Now she passed the CA exams, then took up IAS, I mean civil services exam, that also she cleared. And she opted for IFS. She was the first rank in the entire those days. So she stood first. She chose IFS. Now she is well settled. The point I am trying to say is, perseverance is not giving up within that 108. See, this 180 minutes, is it common to, are you sharing out of anybody's time? It is your own exclusive time. Agree with me? This 100 marks, are you sharing it with anybody? Its own exclusive time, marks allotted to you. So in that, how many marks you are able to grab in that 180 minutes is left to you. Nobody can have a role or nobody can prevent you from toiling every minute to score, minute by minute, mark by mark, till your papers are grabbed or that 180 minutes lapses, isn't it? So use your that determination. See, when you get a tough paper, psychologically you will have to get geared up. Here is a challenge and I am the best to handle this. That positive feeling, ICAI is trying to test me more robustly and I am equipped to face it and take it as a battle and give your best. You will definitely succeed. Then comes, of course, Sachin Tendulkar. He says, the only thing that was in my mind was I want to play for India one day. So that passion took him to that level of setting world record of 100 centuries, which I don't know whether at all anybody can break. And if you don't plan where you want to be in life, you may end up where you don't want to. That is the worst thing that can happen to us. And planning, of course, these are all hints. Hourly, weekly, you can plan. And time allocation, approach to syllabus, priority of portions. Divide all your syllabus into ABC category. A category of portion, questions will most invariably will come and good number of marks. 15 marks, 20 marks, I mean more than 12 marks. B category of portions, now and then they keep asking 7-8 marks. I mean 5 to 10 marks. C category, once in a while they ask short notes, 2-3 marks. This ABC analysis is not for omitting any portions. It is only, see, A category is more important. B category is reasonably important. C category is less important. In all the three, what is the common word? Important. And why it is categorized like that? To proportionately allocate the time. One chapter falling in A category with 20 pages, spend 40 hours. Another chapter falling in B category, 20 pages, spend 20 hours. Another category falling in C category, 20 pages, spend 2 hours. But don't omit. And that is proportionately devoting time and effort and attention. For that you are classified. And habit of writing, inculcate it, because legibility, clarity, quality is very important. And without any distraction, you will have to devote the time. Preparation, you have one basic material, one reference material at the final level, which can be one textbook, the ICAI Board of Studies material. So textbook and Board of Studies material, which one for which subject is basic and which one is referencer, that will decide based on experience and consultation with your seniors. So familiarization round, fast mode. Comprehending round, in-depth study, slow mode. And mastering round, moderate via medium. And finally, revision by model exam. This is what I have summarized for you. And practice to perform gives you an edge by improving speed and accuracy and removes fear and tension. That anxiety will be gone. See, when you write 2 model exams for every subject, you are writing in the month of October 16 model exams for 8 subjects. So the 17th exam you are going to write is the real exam. Actually, I asked one girl student, first attempt you failed, second attempt you got All India rank. What happened? She said, I gained experience in the first attempt. Why do you want to go to the exam hall and gain experience? Write model exam and gain experience so that in real exam, straight away you can excel. So, sharpens the ability to understand the questions. Even understanding the question needs practice. Only by model exams you will understand. Otherwise, you will read the question and start answering it. Halfway through you will realize this is not what has been asked. Something that you will score out and restart. You may complete answering, get the marks, but you have lost 7 or 8 minutes, critical minutes at that point in time. That should not be the thing. And enable better presentation of answers. So you will know how to point by point or para by para or step by step or working notes. All those things makes world of difference. You should help the examiner to help you to get more marks. You write here and say for remaining answer go to page 30. Make it complicated for him searching for answers. He will get irritated. 1 or 2 marks will be lesser than what he would have otherwise given you. So these are all things, peripheral things, how to present your answers. So 2 model exams for each subject and raise your bar. And exam techniques, time management is very, very important. 15 minutes you have for questions reading now, question paper reading. In that, besides glancing through the questions, one strategy you must adopt. What is that strategy? As you are reading the question paper in that 15 minutes, divide all the questions you are going to answer into 3 categories. First category, known, less time consuming. So known, less time consuming. Definitely 30 to 40 marks will belong to that. Which means you will quickly write all those things with clarity, fresh mind, and you would have 30, 40 marks in your pocket. I mean, significant marks in your pocket by the time first 1 hour goes away. Then, next category, known but time consuming. So that you, after finishing the first category, you start answering the second category. Third category will be what? I don't want to say unknown. Third category, others. All others. You put it like basket. If that basket is empty, happy. Feel happy. Everything should come in the first 2 categories. That's the ideal way of preparing. But sometimes you can't help it. So third category will be there. For that, after finishing the first 2 category answering, third category you may have 10 minutes, 5 minutes. Break your head. Something relevant that comes to your mind for those, write it. Attempt it. Don't skip it. Because it is possible that that question is out of syllabus And the examination committee may say all the students who attempted it will be given 5 marks. Why lose that? So keep like that. And so attempting all questions is very, very important, with legibility, clarity, and working notes, assumptions, accuracy, quality, brevity, all that time management is very, very important. And performance gap comes because of the attitude, pessimism, optimism. See, in life you are always taught to be optimistic, isn't it? But I would be slightly different in advising you. When you are preparing for the exams, be pessimistic. When you are writing the exam, be optimistic. See, somebody who thought, when birds fly, why not humans fly? So writer brothers, they invented aeroplane. They were optimistic we can fly, they invented aeroplane. But somebody thought, what if some engine problem comes halfway through in the sky? Something goes wrong. He invented parachute, isn't it? So he was pessimistic, therefore he invented parachute. So I want you to be pessimistic when you are preparing for the exam, so that you will prepare even for the most unexpected pattern of question paper, most difficult question, you prepare. But when you walk into the examination hall, be optimistic. If not me, who else going to pass? If not now, when else am I going to pass? That positive attitude, that optimism you should have when you go into the examination hall. But when you are preparing, prepare, equipping yourself with all the parachute that is required, so that even in the worst unexpected paper, you will land safely with the minimum marks to qualify with the pass. So endurance, that's what, 3 hours, you have no right to come out of the examination hall. Even if you complete it, revise it. But once you come out, don't discuss about it. The evaluation job is not yours. At least till the last paper gets over. Because the student who wrote the wrong answer will convince the student who wrote the right answer that your answer is wrong. And you, the next day paper, you will bungle in that worry. Because human mind is generally, it misuses the imagination to worry on unwarranted things. So that you should never give room. In fact, the best answer I have got from a student is, because everybody was telling one day, tough paper, out of, I mean, comprehension and all that. So I have given this advice to my students. So I want to test what is, so I called up and said, how was the paper? Okay. Answer was, okay. How did you write? Whatever I could, I wrote. No evaluation at all. See, you, after you come out of the examination, you cannot undo what you have done. And the moment you come out of the examination hall, that paper does not exist in your life. What exists in your life? The next paper. Focus on that paper and give your best. So, one by one, but it's a battle, non-emotional battle, give your best. And this endurance test, what I have done is what? When the toughest papers, I mean, I'm exaggerating, don't think that will be the real story. And so that you will understand the point I am trying to say, suddenly you will be wondering, is this the paper for which I prepared? I mean, it can be like that, staring at you, glaring at you with unknown. But remember 3 things. One, if it is tough for you, it is going to be tough for everybody. See, that will give you a sense of comfort. See, when somebody comes and says, your house is on fire, what is the emotion? Same person comes and the whole village is on fire. Oh, everybody is on fire, no problem. So that, psychological. So remember, it's not an individual paper. It is paper given to all 80,000 students, 1 lakh students. So it is tough for you, it is tough for everybody. Number 2, definitely some percentage are going to pass. Some percentage are going to fail. Now, to which category you want to belong, you decide. Obviously,
you have to belong to the category of those who are going to pass. Third point is, institute will not fail all the students. That's a guarantee. Because then their reputation will be at stake. These people don't know how to set the paper, how to conduct the exam. They are failing everybody. That they want, they, by moderation at least, they will make 5% to pass. Why not belong to the 5%? Let me put it this way, positive way. Even in the toughest paper, if that for 1 hour, 80 minutes, I mean the 180 minutes, the 3 hours, if you put your best, point by point, brick by brick, trying to score, maximize the score, and come out, I guarantee you will qualify, you will pass. Your effort, labor will not go unrewarded at all. Let me give a practical example. Two students, shocked by looking at the paper, reasonably well prepared. One psychologically gave up, saying, anyway, I'm going to fail. Why I should waste my time? After 1 hour, he walked out. Why? Because before 1 hour, he cannot walk out. That is the restriction. No? When we wrote, it was half an hour. Now they made it because they want to, if you can change your mind. For that compulsion is given, but he waits for that 1 hour, walks away. Another student says, remembers these 3 points I told. The student cannot fail everybody. Let me try to be in the passing percentage, so he gives his best. Now the result comes. What is the answer you expect from me? Next sentence. First one failed, second one passed. No. The reality was, first one scored 18 marks. The second one scored 32 marks. Which means both are failed, isn't it? But it goes to the examination committee. And they take feedback from parents, students, board of studies. Then they decide, no, this paper is very lengthy. This paper has certain, you know, things beyond the syllabus. So they brainstorm and decide, in this paper we are going to give 8 marks as moderation. So 18 becomes 26, 32 becomes 40. And both the students had 50s, 60s, 70s in all other papers. This is the only paper. Now look at what the blender, the first person has done. By giving your best, you are extending your arm, ICAI is ready to pull it out. But by walking out or giving up, you are actually keeping your hand behind your back, reconciled that I don't want to pass. Don't belong to that category of students. Wrong notions are there. ICAI will not allow anybody to pass beyond a predetermined pass percentage. That's a wrong notion. Pass percentage varies based on your performance. Attempt center-wise discrimination, no. Some people in Chennai go to Tirupati and write. Somebody goes to Shimoga and write, pass percentage there is more. All these are all unfounded, misdirected intelligence and research findings. Allocation of marks is step by step. Even incomplete answers, you may get proportionate marks. Point by point, step by step, you will get marks. And out of syllabus, as I told you, make an attempt to the best of your ability. Then writing section numbers, case laws, not mandatory. Substance, if you write correctly, that will get significant marks. If you remember section number or case law, you can add on. That may get 5 or 10% addition. That's ornamental to the answer, not inevitable for an answer. So that way you remember it. Then, so never give up. That I already told you, that example of my own student. Never give up or abort your attempt. So with that, I wish you all the very best. May God bless you with success. As I mentioned earlier, I hope to see all of you as colleagues in my profession. God bless all of you. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
share and explain them, whatever you want to do. Anyone?
Students who are virtually participated, thank you very much. Sorry for that initial some disruption, but I hope you could listen to the rest of the session.
Sir?
Yeah, yeah. Chant, yeah. Yeah, yeah.
Sir, on behalf of students, I'll ask you a question.
Yeah, yeah, please.
Generally, the students have to make that up to eat that people prefer nutrition for the meal.
Yeah.
And once we enter into the articles, like how to balance them, like
yeah.
The article, like
yeah, see, this journey of academics with practical training is an interesting but at the same time challenging experience. You have to strike a balance. So when you are attending articleship training, try to the resource, the time as a resource becomes more significant to effectively deploy it for both the purposes. So my only request is don't wait for study all this to come for you to prepare for exam. Every day, morning 2 hours, evening 2 hours. I mean, I'm giving the maximum benchmark. But if that is not possible, 1.5 hours, 1.5 hours. 1 hour, 1 hour. Half an hour, half an hour. Make it as an habit. Morning before getting ready and going to the office, at least half an hour, 1 hour you prepare. The continuity you must maintain. Similarly, in the evening before going to bed on working days. If you are attending classes, that itself will be 2 hours classes, that is a good preparation time. Weekends, try to maximize, at least because you may have other things also, at least 8 hours, 6 to 8 hours on weekends when you are not going to office or doing office work. Like that, if you keep offloading your burden consistently on a month to month, week to week, day to day, then by the time you reach study holidays, you will not find it difficult at all to comprehend 8 subjects, voluminous syllabus, divergent papers. It will all fall in place. Actually, students, if you can do this and offload significant preparation before study holidays you will start enjoying it and you will be trying to master the subject and presentation only with a view to maximize the outcome, possibility of a rank. So that you will be able to achieve. So consistent, actually if you, I've interacted with many rank holders, toppers, top 3 rank holders. I've read the interviews and articles written by them in students' newsletter and in other forums of media also. One thing common about all of them, they said we prepared like we used to prepare in our school exams. That same discipline, in school what happens, one chapter completed, teaching complete, weekly test. Then 2-3 put together, monthly test. Then 6-7 put together, quarterly test, midterm test. So many tests that if you follow that habit now, CA will become a child's play for you. The moment you migrate to college academic preparation style for CA exam, they don't go together. In college, unfortunately, you know, you think first time you have got the freedom in life to freak out. You need not carry all books. One notebook, sample book is enough. This side it will be one subject, another side in another subject, in between multiple subjects, and that will be used for multi-purpose. That in CA, that you know, once you lose that discipline, it is very difficult to bring back that. Robust preparation. So follow that school discipline, all the subjects will fall in place.
I have 2 questions.
Yeah.
One about the students' vision towards the future. So
yeah.
What kind of future we are having? Many students are asking us. And another question I want to ask is about the at par with global expectation.
Yeah. Yeah.
How much our preparation is.
Yeah. See, actually, yesterday the president of ICAI went on record to say they are rolling out new syllabus. See, once in 5 to 7 years, the new syllabus upgradation happens and rolled out only to meet the global expectations. And
in terms of, that is for the second question. The first question is, you know, CAs of India have immense potential, not only in India but also overseas, provided you embrace technology and also the new skill sets that are required. And more opportunities are evolving because there is dearth of this youth, there is dearth of youth itself and also the skill sets across the globe. And if only we can empower ourselves by the qualification and skills and also the soft skills, technological skills, you can settle down anywhere in the world. That is the bright future that awaits your arrival as a chartered accountant. So, but only thing is, you must have 360 degree vision to complete your personality with qualification, professional skills, technological skills, managerial skills, soft skills. So in this blend of these, at least two out of these four skills, if you have, then you have a bright future to take off. Because, you know, the world is looking at India as the future, as an alternative to China for their investments, the prediction is by 2027 we will overtake Germany to become the fourth largest. We overtook England recently to become the fifth largest, and we will overtake Germany in 2027. 2030 we will overtake Japan to become the third largest and compete with China and USA. There will be no stopping at all, no looking back at all. So you are qualifying at the right time to get into the mainstream. And I have visited, just as a matter of statistics, at least 100 plus countries. And there is no country where I have not seen an Indian CA who is settled there. So that much of opportunity spread across the globe is there. Of course, it is your choice whether to stay in India or stay outside India. In fact, some of my students who are well settled abroad, they used to have guilty feelings. Sir, after all, I am well settled, but I am not within India. I used to tell them, don't feel guilty. It is not necessary that you should be within India, but India should be within you. Wherever you are, if you operate with the mindset of an Indian and you achieve anything, credit will come to India. And you are earning good amount of money here and you are sending, repatriating significant amount to invest in India. That is patriotism. Actually, that is what is expected of non-resident Indians. Whereas some of the Indians who may be settled in India may be looting India and depositing in Swiss bank. That is what is not desirable, isn't it? So which is patriotism? Not being in India is not patriotism. But promoting the cause of India, whether you are anywhere in the world, that is patriotism.
Any questions, Swami?
Yeah, please.
Introduce yourself and please ask the question.
Good afternoon, sir. Good afternoon. I'm Arvind. So I just wanted to ask your opinion on the new scheme which is set to be implemented soon. So
I knew the news that they are reviewing the syllabus and coming out, but I have not studied the contents of the syllabus. 1 year back, the intent was to make it like he was, Ratnagiri was asking. The intent is to make it as an international curriculum so that even foreign students will be able to join. Of course, there will be only two subjects on which options will be given to study their own subjects, like taxation and company law. Corporate allied laws, one paper, taxation, one paper. So barring these two, all other things should be applicable across the globe. That kind of a syllabus orientation was being contemplated, but what is to be rolled out, I have not seen it yet.
When can the students expect the new scheme to
be? That's what I mean, he has said they are in the process. It has some approvals of the ministry, government and all that. Generally, it will take 3 to 6 months. But even if it is rolled out, it will be prospective. It will not apply. They will give a point of time from that exam, this syllabus is required, so that the old students will not be burdened. straight away to migrate from this syllabus to that syllabus. Please, you go ahead, because they are the current office bearers. They will know maybe direct answer to your question. Yeah.
So as of now, there is no school syllabus coming news. So
can you come here and answer there? What's your school?
For this question, I will put a closing remark on this. So, as far as recent communication is from the head office of ICAI, till 24, there is no change at all. So, old syllabus is continuing. Even though the new syllabus is coming out, three parallel attempts will be conducted by the ICAI. Like, you have a chance of appearing. The same thing had in November 2008. So, the November 2008, the syllabus, when at the time it got introduced, at the time it was a global speaker as a global standard. This is the syllabus which are in now. In that situation, it's very simple thing, like a parallel attempt will be continuing, which means that technically speaking, November 24, May 25 and May 25, November exams, the parallel attempts will continue. So they will give the opportunity for the student. In case if the current syllabus student is continuing in a bigger percentage, they will think on about one more attempt, which means May 26. So that is the last communication we had with the thing. So, as I put my closing remarks, I want to share some of my moments really which was happened in my life, as Manoharan sir said. You mentioned about an IFS student that had in my firm, my partner called Vikas Sharma, my firm which belongs to the Hazaribagh, Jharkhand. I am the partner in a firm where the Hazaribagh, Jharkhand. This guy never failed in any of the examination. I still remember that attempt was November 2008 attempt. He appeared for advanced accounting paper number 1. That time, you know, like we were in the Chennai for the coaching. And one of the faculty who taught us a particular syllabus for 2 months, unfortunately, that particular question was not asked in the examination. Everyone got stumbled. So he appeared for 56 marks and he got rejected, accounting paper number 1. So he had a mindset that he don't want to continue in the examination. So he want to go for the next attempt. That is about May or June, because that time Manmohan Singh sir was the Prime Minister, so election is going to be conducted on May 2009. So he wanted to see institutes having and thing, because we were waiting for the election day. So, you know, like one exams account got completed and he waited for 8 hours to take a decision whether he want to go with the same attempt or multiple attempt. He sat in the Ranchi railway station and he decided to go with the same attempt. The results came on July 14, I still remember that. He got exactly 14 in the accounting paper. And he got 400 as a total. My partner, old example from my firm. And second example I want to share it with you, May 16 attempt, Sriram. And like All India 1, he got 609. I have been touched with that from foundation days onwards. He got 601. At the time, a chartered accountant from Rajasthan called Vinit Sadani, he was the record breaker, 621. The results came up. Sriram thought that except the law, any paper, like he was confident, more than 70. Law, okay, now I did well, but definitely because result come that day before, we had a All India Students Conference at Sindhir Public School. We were chatting. And he was telling that like, பண்ணிருக்க ரேங்க் வருமா கண்டிப்பாக ரேங்க் வரும் அண்ட் என்ன ரேங்க் தெரியாது தட் கான்ஃபிடன்ஸ் அண்ட் த ரிசல்ட்ஸ் கே ஹி காட் 44 இன் லா பேப்பர் எக்ஸப்ட் லா ஆல் பேப்பர் ஹி காட் 70 பிளஸ் ஸோ அதனால் ஒரு பேப்பரை வச்சு டோன்ட் டிஸ்கஸ் தட் சர்ஸ் ஆன் எக்ஸாம்பிளில் அந்த 16 அண்ட் 24 அண்ட் 32 ஐ ரிமெம்பர் தட் எக்ஸாம்பிள் ஸோ த டூ திங்ஸ் ஐ வாண்ட் டு ஷேர் ஸோ தேங்க்யூ சார் தேங்க்ஸ் ஃபார் யுவர் வண்டர்ஃபுல் ப்ரெசன்டேஷன் ஸோ ஐ தேங்க் செங்கல்பட்டு சிகாசா சேர்மன் ஆனந்த் சார் ஐ தேங்க் வேலூர் சிகாசா சேர்மன் சி எஸ் ராமச்சந்திர சார் ஐ தேங்க் ஈரோடு சிகாசா சேர்மன் ஸ்ரீ பிரதீப் சார் ஐ தேங்க் திருப்பூர் சிகாசா சேர்மன் எம்பி வரதராஜன் சார் ஐ தேங்க் சதீஷ் கோயம்புத்தூர் சிகாசா சேர்மன் ஐ தேங்க் சேர்மன் ராஜகுரு ஆஃப் மதுரை ஐ தேங்க் விஜய் சாரதி ஆஃப் கும்பகோணம் ஐ தேங்க் பாலசுப்ரமணியம் சார் ஆஃப் திருநெல்வேலி I thank Vidubala Madam of Tiruchirappalli. I thank Priti sir, Priti of CA Priti of Thoothukudi. And I thank Mayur of Pondicherry. And I thank all the Sicasa chairman and Sicasa student for the wonderful day. Ramchandra sir, I have from it. Second, I have CC Ramchandra. So I thank Suneshwaran of Sivagasi. So 12 branches of Tamil Nadu and 1 branch of Pondicherry. So thank you and all the very best on behalf of the Sicasa team, on behalf of past chairman Padma Shri Manoharan sir, on behalf of the Salem branch. And thank you all. I request MC to take over the day.
Webinar. Your presence and participation have made this event meaningful one and very deeply, and we are deeply honored and humbled by your support. First and foremost, I would like to thank our esteemed speaker, Padma Shri CATA Manoharan sir, past president of ICAI, for raising this event with his presence and sharing invaluable insights and wisdom with us. Your presence has truly elevated the event and enriched our knowledge. I would like to express my deep sense of gratitude to CABA Shankar sir, Sicasa chairman of Salem branch, for his unwavering support. I would also like to thank Sicasa chairman of Coimbatore, Madurai, Erode, Kumbakonam, Pondicherry, Chengalpattu, Tirunelveli, Thoothukudi, Tiruchi, Velur, Sivagasi and Tirupur branches of their branches for their immense support. Next, I would like to extend my sincere appreciation to our Sicasa committee members who have put in countless hours of effort to ensure that every aspect of this event was meticulously planned and executed. In conclusion, I would like to once again thank each and every one of you for your invaluable contribution to this event. Thank you all.